Morning and welcome to the 2022 Indonesia Design for Greater Efficiency Ceremonial Event. My name is Anggita and I will become your host for today. The event is held to mark the beginning of the partnership between six universities in Indonesia with IFC to encourage green building practice to future young professional. Dan selamat pagi Bapak dan Ibu sekalian dan selamat datang di Ceremonial Design for Greater Efficiency atau yang disingkat dengan DFGE Indonesia. Acara ini diadakan sebagai tanda dimulainya jalinan kemitraan antara 6 universitas dengan IFC untuk mendorong praktik bangunan hijau oleh calon profesional muda. So, Philip and Angel, we're going to do this by bilingual. So sometimes I speak in English and sometimes I speak in Indonesia. Hopefully that's okay with you. And starting this year, the six university, including Universitas Trisakti, Universitas 11 Maret, Universitas Brawijaya, Universitas Pembangunan Jaya, Universitas Atmajaya Yogyakarta, dan Universitas Widya Kartika will begin to deliver the Design for Greater Efficiency course to guide students and young professional in building and promoting resource efficient design. Jadi mulai tahun ini, 6 universitas yaitu Universitas Trisakti, Universitas 11 Maret, Universitas Brawijaya, Universitas Pembangunan Jaya, Universitas Atmajaya Yogyakarta, dan Universitas Widya Kartika akan mulai melaksanakan kelas DFGE sebagai bagian dari upaya mempromosikan perancangan bangunan efisien sumber daya kepada profesional muda dan mahasiswa di bidang arsitektur. And today we would like to offer some time for the university representative that be with us today from the six new university that joined the program to give their remarks about this partnership. Also, this expanding partnership of the FT program in Indonesia will be impossible to have without the support of Switzerland State Secretariat for Economic Affairs, or SECO. And today we have the honor to have Mr. Philip Orga as the head of Swiss Economic Cooperation with us today to give his remark. Jadi hari ini kita akan mendengarkan beberapa sambutan dari perwakilan-perwakilan universitas terkait dengan kerjasama ini. Dan kerjasama ini tentunya mustahil bisa terlaksana tanpa dukungan dari Switzerland State Secretariat for Economic Affairs atau singkatnya SECO. Dan hari ini kita berterima kasih atas kesediaan waktu dari Mr. Philip Orga dan juga Ibu Dewi Tio yang berkenan untuk hadir dan memberikan sedikit sambutan bagi kita semua. So before we begin, I would like to invite Angelo Tan as acting lead of Indonesia Green Building Program to welcome all our honorable guests and participants of the training of trainers that will be held right after this session. There will be 35 faculty members that will join training today. So without further ado, Angelo, the floor is all yours.
Thank you so much, Anggita. To Mr. Philip Orga, head of the Swiss Economic Cooperation at the Embassy of Switzerland in Indonesia, Bapak Hadi Prabowo, Dean of Planning and Civil Engineering Department at Universitas Trisakti, Bapak Sholihin Asad, Dean of Faculty of Engineering, Universitas 11 Maret, Bapak Lucky Handoko, Dean of Engineering Faculty, Universities Atma Jaya, Yogyakarta, Bapak Hadi Soyono, Dean of Engineering Faculty, Universitas Brawijaya, Bapak Agustinus Agus Setiawan, Dean of Technology and Design Faculty, Universitas Pembangunan Jaya, Bapak F. Pio Suprobo, Rector, Universitas Widya Kartika, Lecturer and Facilitator for the DFG Training in Indonesia, Pak Jatmika, members of the academic community, built environment professionals, guests and friends, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, and a good morning to all of you. As the world continues to grapple with the COVID-19 pandemic, the problem of climate change hasn't stopped. As built environment professionals, we need to ensure that our buildings operate as efficiently and environmentally friendly as possible. We also need to ensure a sustainable future by developing the new cohort of sustainable built environment professionals. Designing for Greater Efficiency, or DFGE, is a course aimed at senior building design students and working professionals. DFGE covers the fundamentals of energy and resource efficiency measures in building design from a technical and commercial perspective. The course uses case studies and examples to teach students how to design for resource efficiency and how to sell those designs in a commercial setting. DFGE is offered by IFC, a member of the World Bank Group, to encourage resource efficiency in the construction sector. There are 7 countries and 36 universities in Asia, Africa, and South America that have joined DFG program so far. DFG in Indonesia was launched in 2018, and since then we've had partnerships to deliver DFGE through 6 universities. These are Universitas Indonesia, Universitas Diponegoro, Universitas Gajah Mada, Institute Teknologi Bandung, Institute Teknologi 10 November, and Universitas Tarumanagara, which joined from the period 2018 to 2019. Today, we celebrate a significant milestone as we add 6 more universities to expand our universities program. On behalf of the International Finance Corporation, I would like to extend our gratitude to Universitas Trisakti, Universitas Brawijaya, Universitas Sebelas Maret, Universitas Atma Jaya Yogyakarta, Universitas Wijayakartika, and Universitas Pembangunan Jaya, who joined us this year. We also express our gratitude to SECO for their ongoing support of the DFGE program, which now allows us to implement DFGE in 8 cities in Indonesia: Jakarta, Tangerang, Bandung, Semarang, Yogyakarta, Surakarta, Malang, and Surabaya. Up to December 2021, DFGE Indonesia has more than 370 students that have joined and are benefiting through the program through our university partners. In the future, IFC and the university partners will have a design competition that involves various building stakeholders, and we will also establish a learning hub for ongoing collaboration. Once again, thank you so much for the opportunity to partner with you on this meaningful program. Thank you.
Thank you, Angelo. Before we begin with the representative, I think we should give Mr. Orga a time for give his remarks. Please, Mr. Orga, the place is yours.
Thank you. Thanks a lot, Ibu Anggita, and to all the deans of Trisakti, Sebelas Maret, Atma Jaya, Yogyakarta, Brawijaya, Pembangunan Jaya, Widyakartika Universities, Angelo Tan from IFC, Green Building Practitioners, and academics, ladies and gentlemen, selamat pagi to everyone. And it is my great pleasure to be here today and participate in today's event, which marks, as Angelo said, a very important milestone to further promote green building practices in Indonesia. And I'm the head of economic cooperation and development here at the Swiss Embassy in Jakarta and represent SECO at this event today. Just for information, that SECO is the Swiss government's agency in charge of executing Switzerland's economic cooperation and development program with our partner countries. And this, of course, also includes Indonesia. In Indonesia, the aim of our program is to contribute to a more competitive, resilient, and equitable Indonesian economy. And we do this by supporting projects in the areas of skills development, public financial management, sustainable urban development, tourism, value chains, and also access to finance. And actually, one of Switzerland's longest programs with Indonesia is the Green Building Initiative, which is implemented by IFC. And Switzerland has been supporting this initiative globally since 2012, so now for exactly a decade. And we are very excited and fully committed to supporting IFC with the implementation of this important program for another 4 years. The program was initially, and I think that's interesting, was initially designed to provide technical assistance to the government of Indonesia to mainstream green building practices across the country. And Switzerland is proud that together with the Ministry of Public Works and Housing and IFC, we successfully supported the introduction of green building codes in Jakarta, in Bandung, and Semarang, and also the issuance of green building regulations by the central government. And over time, and with increased government capacity, the program responded to market needs and shifted its activities to address the capacity gap at market level by introducing green building codes, green building courses at a selected number of universities in Indonesia. And we are very pleased that today an additional 6 universities will join the Design for Greater Efficiency program. So a very warm welcome to all of you. Indonesia has actually been a role model for many other countries when it comes to promoting green building practices and developing green building courses. And we have received a lot of very positive feedback from the industry about this program, which is a sign that the courses taught at the universities equip students with skills that are demanded by the private sector. And I think that is absolutely key if we want to make this program a success in the long run. And actually almost 100% or 100%, I'm not fully up to date with the latest figures of the students that attended the courses in the past, they got a job right after graduation. So this number and the fact that more universities are joining the program today means that the first phase was a success. So here I would also like to congratulate IFC for a very good first phase. And we do hope that the six of you, so the six new universities that we will be adding to the program, will be able to convince even more universities to take part in this program and ensure that future architects are equipped with much needed green building skills, which is key to move Indonesia towards a greener development trajectory. So with that, I would like to conclude and just say that let's keep up the good work and get ready to green Indonesia's future. Terima kasih, thank you, and I wish you an excellent training.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Orga, for your support. We hope that we can keep doing this great work together and create a wider green building implementation around the world and especially in Indonesia. And now we will hear from Bapak Hadi Prabowo as the Dean of Planning and Civil Engineering Department from Universitas Trisakti. Silakan Bapak Hadi, untuk waktu dan tempat kami persilakan.
Terima kasih Mbak Rina. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Om Swastiastu, Namo Buddhaya, dan Salam Kebajikan. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. The Honorable Bapak Korni Figueredo, Operation Manager at Green Building Market Transformation Program, Climate Business Department, IFC. Honorable Bapak Angelo Tan, Acting Lead Indonesia Green Building Program, IFC, and Honorable Bapak Philip Orga, Head Swiss Economic Corporation. Kemudian yang terhormat Bapak F. Prio Suprobo, STMT, Rektor Universitas Widya Kartika. Yang terhormat Dr. Teh Insinyur Solihin Asap, MT, Dekan Fakultas Teknis UNS. Kemudian yang terhormat Dr. Eng Luki Handoko, STM Eng, Dekan Fakultas Teknik UAJY. Kemudian yang terhormat Profesor Insinyur Hadi Suryono, STMT PhD, Ibu Asian Eng, Dekan Fakultas Teknik UB. Kemudian yang terhormat Bapak Agustinus Setiawan, STMT, Dekan Fakultas Teknologi dan Desain UPJ. Dear guests, ladies and gentlemen, today we meet to sign the license and cooperation agreement between the International Finance Corporation, IFC, and six faculties or universities. Thank you to IFC for being willing to cooperate with us, Faculty of Civil Engineering and Planning, Universitas Trisakti. This collaboration is in accordance with the program launched by IFC, namely the Green Building Market Transformation Program. As we all know that green building is one solution to overcome climate change, Universitas Trisakti as an educational institution is called to contribute to the successful understanding of green building through teaching students. Therefore, training is needed for lecturers to increase knowledge and implementation of green building. The International Finance Corporation, IFC, has provided program related to green building learning materials. Therefore, IFC strongly support Universitas Trisakti in its collaboration to increasing the understanding of green building for students as future leaders. We hope that the license and cooperation agreement can run smoothly and successfully, which is beneficial for the faculties and universities and can increase knowledge about green building for lecturer and student. Bapak Dekan yang saya hormati, tentunya kerjasama ini dapat kita kembangkan yang lebih jauh lagi, bahwa di dalam perguruan tinggi ada Tridharma Perguruan Tinggi, tentunya kerjasama bisa kita kembangkan dalam Tridharma Perguruan Tinggi, yaitu pendidikan pengajaran, penelitian, dan pengabdian kepada masyarakat. Nah, saat ini FTSP mempunyai 4 prodi, yaitu S1 dan S2 arsitektur, dengan kelompok bidang keahlian sejarah teori kritik arsitektur, teknologi bangunan, perancangan arsitektur, kota dan permukiman. Sedang S1 dan S2 teknik sipil dengan kelompok keahlian struktur, sumber daya air, transportasi, dan manajemen konstruksi. Semoga akan dilakukan kerjasama antar fakultas atau prodi agar kita dapat sharing ilmu pengetahuan melalui kolaborasi agar kita maju bersama. Serta kerjasama nantinya selalu mendapat berkah dari Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, Tuhan Yang Maha Esa. Thank you, terima kasih.
Terima kasih Pak Hadi atas sambutannya. Thank you for the remarks, Pak Hadi. And then next we will hear from Bapak Solihin Asad as the Dean of Faculty Engineering from Universitas 11 Maret. Bapak Solihin Asad, silakan Bapak, waktu dan tempat dipersilakan.
Terima kasih Bu Anggita. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Selamat pagi, very good morning, distinguished guests, Bapak Philip, Olga, and Ibu Dewi from Swiss Embassy, Swiss Economic Cooperation, Pak Angel Tan, and also all the partners, the deans and the directors from 6 University, Universitas Trisakti, Universitas Brawijaya, Universitas Atmajaya, Universitas Pembangunan Jaya, and Universitas Widya Kartika. Yeah. All the mentors, green building practitioners, and all the participants of the training of the trainer or TOT, designed for the greater efficiency. Yeah. My name is Rolin Asad, I'm currently the Dean of Faculty of Engineering, Universitas 11 Maret, or UNS, yeah. On behalf of the Universitas 11 Maret and all of my colleagues who participate in these trainings, I would like to extend my sincere gratitude and also my high appreciation for the IFC for taking us and bringing us to be part of this community. Thank you very much. We are really honored to be part of this community. Yeah. I would like also to say thank you and mention to special mention to my colleague Dr. Wiwi Setianingsi, who already initiate the communication with IFC and also persuade them, so that starting long time ago, things several weeks ago, and then right now we are ready to assign the what they call the cooperation, the agreement with IFC. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Yeah, thank you very much, Bu. Ladies and gentlemen, IFC strategic collaboration will further improve our understandings on green buildings, best practice, and strengthen our connection with the green building community. Ladies and gentlemen, Bapak Ibu sekalian, as academia, most of us who are coming here in this trainings came from the Department of Architecture, and I myself from Department of Civil Engineering. We are doing research, we are doing also, we are teaching our students, and we participating in a community service with many aspect of green building also. Ladies and gentlemen, but we cannot ignore that some of our knowledge and our design were built from our experience, from our ancestors, our local experience. It's provide that's many experience from a long time ago, and they prove that they live in harmony with the people and nature in a long time. Actually, from them we collect the local wisdom and local context to our design. Just an example, design in our traditional houses, for example, is very excellent with ventilation without electricity. We know how they manage the site excellently, and then we can learn how they preserve the water, for example. Ladies and gentlemen, the combination of our local knowledge and our local context and the perspective with the green building community provides a more comprehensive understanding and accelerates the implementation of green building practice through education, research, and community services. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm quite sure that this strategic partnership with IFC and many universities will benefit students, will benefit our community, and inshallah, will save the world. Ladies and gentlemen, lastly, I'm sure that this training will enlighten us. Now, I wish you have a wonderful experience in this 4-day training, and we are looking forward to collaborate with you all. Stay safe, stay healthy. Terima kasih. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Terima kasih, matur nuwun semuanya, Pak Iko dan semuanya.
Ya, terima kasih Pak Solihin, terima kasih Bapak dan Ibu, dan thank you for your kind words, Bapak, and enthusiasm for green buildings and sustainability, and hopefully that our programs is able to support you on doing more on that subject. And next, we will hear from Bapak Luki Handoko as Dean of Engineering Faculty from Universitas Atmajaya, Yogyakarta, who unfortunately is unable to join us today. However, he will be represented by Bapak Nikolaus Nino Ardiansyah as Vice Dean of Engineering Faculty. Bapak Nino, apakah sudah bergabung?
Sudah.
Baik, silakan Bapak, waktu dan tempat dipersilakan.
Baik, thanks Miss Anggita, to the Honorable Mr. Angelo Tan as Acting Lead Indonesia Green Building Program, EFG, and Mr. Philip Orga as Head Swiss Economic Corporation, Dean of the Faculty of Engineering from Trisakti University, 11 Maret University, Brawijaya University, Pembangunan Jaya University, and Rector of Vidya Kartika University. Also, all the training participant and working committee. Good morning, healthy greeting to all of us. Let me represent the Dean of the Faculty of Engineering, who is currently unable to attend, to deliver his remarks this morning. It's great to be here to be a part of the Design for Greater Efficiency training activity this morning. One of the most important foundation in preparing the curriculum at Universitas Atmajaya Yogyakarta, mandated by the Chancellor through the Quality Assurance Office, is the psychological foundation, so that the existing curriculum is able to encourage students' curiosity and motivate lifelong learning that adapts to the needs prevalent in society. Issues regarding the environment, energy, and sustainability cannot be separated from the essential needs in the engineering field involved in building design work. Therefore, Faculty of Engineering Universitas Atmajaya Yogyakarta really appreciates and supports cooperation in encouraging the growth of green building and increasing awareness and experience with green building design. In this case, related to the Green Building Market Transformation Program, one of the components of which is excellence in design for efficiency, larger to reduce the resource intensity of building materials. Finally, hopefully this training can increase the capacity and capability of the participant and can give special color to the curriculum developed. Welcome to the training. Thank you. Terima kasih.
Terima kasih, Pak Nino. Okay, so next we will hear from Bapak Agustinus Agus Setiawan as Dean of Technology and Design Faculty from Universitas Pembangunan Jaya. Pak Agus, apakah sudah bergabung?
Ya, sudah, Bu.
Baik, silakan Bapak untuk waktu dan tempat kami persilakan.
Terima kasih. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Shalom, Om Swastiastu, Namo Buddhaya, salam sejahtera, salam kebajikan untuk kita semua. Good morning, distinguished guest Mr. Philip Orga and Ms. Dewi Tio from Swiss Embassy, Mr. Angelo Tan from IFC, the respected Dean of Planning and Civil Engineering Department Universitas Trisakti, Bapak Dr. Insinyur A. Hadi Prabowo MT, Dean of Faculty of Engineering Universitas 11 Maret, Dr. Teknik Insinyur Solihin Asad MT, Dean of Engineering Faculty Universitas Atmajaya Yogyakarta, Dr. Engineering Lucky Handoko, STM Engineering, Dean of Engineering Faculty Universitas Brawijaya, Profesor Insinyur Hadi Suyono, STMT, PhD, IPU, ASEAN Engineering, Rektor Universitas Widya Kartika, Bapak F. Priyo Supropo, STMT. First of all, I would like to thank to IFC, especially Professor Jatmika, who has provided the opportunity for Universitas Pembangunan Jaya to join in this activity. One positive step for UPJ to be involved in learning together and collaborating in this training for trainer activity with several top universities from Indonesia, such as Trisakti, Atmajaya Yogyakarta, Universitas Negeri 11 Maret, Universitas Brawijaya, and Widya Kartika University. We hope that through this activity, wider collaboration between universities can be established, which of course will lead to an increase in the competencies of lecturers and students in each university. Issues of climate change, sustainable development, renewable energy are always interesting to study and become a source for many research activity in the future, which can be started from joint activities this morning. This theme is in line with the focus research of the Universitas Pembangunan Jaya, which puts forward the study of urban problems. Finally, I hope this activity can run well and all participants can complete all the TOT training agendas as well as possible. I think that's all from me. Thank you for your attention. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning.
Thank you, Bapak Agus Setiawan, for the kind words and also enthusiasm. And last but not least, we would like to invite Bapak F. Priyo Suprobo as Rector of Universitas Widya Kartika to give his remark. Untuk waktu dan tempat, kami persilahkan. Pak Priyo, apakah sudah bergabung? Apakah ada perwakilan dari Universitas Widya Kartika?
Kelihatannya Pak Priyo belum bergabung ini.
Oh, baik. Atau Pak Ari mungkin bisa memberikan sedikit sambutan Bapak mewakili beliau? Oh, ini barusan. Baik.
Oh iya, iya.
Baru saja masuk. Okay. So, Mr. Suprobo just join us today. Halo, Pak Suprobo.
Halo, Ibu.
Halo Bapak, terima kasih untuk waktunya. Baik Bapak, silakan untuk waktu dan tempat kami persilakan.
Ya, baik, terima kasih saya sampaikan khususnya kepada IFC yang telah juga mengundang kita semua dan juga terutama dari perwakilan SEKO, Mr. Philip Orga, serta Bapak-Ibu sekalian, para undangan dan juga dari Bapak Ibu jajaran pimpinan universitas ya, Universitas Trisakti, Universitas 11 Maret, kemudian Universitas Atmajaya, Brawijaya dan juga Universitas Pembangunan Jaya. Kami dari Universitas Widya Kartika menyampaikan terima kasih bahwa sedianya kesempatan ini jelas-jelas suatu kesempatan yang merupakan awal bagi kami untuk juga ikut ambil bagian gitu ya dalam kampanye ataupun juga lebih kepada implementasi tentang bagaimana green economy mau dibangun di kampus kami juga. Dan kami perlu belajar banyak dari Bapak dan Ibu sekalian, terutama juga kesempatan yang telah diberikan khususnya dari IFC ya, sebagai pimpinan dalam hal ini untuk kampanye kegiatan program ini. Mr. Angelo Tan, ya, terima kasih bahwa semuanya ini juga pasti tidak serta-merta dengan mudahnya untuk kami mengikuti langsung apa-apa yang harus dikerjakan sebagai institusi. Tugas ini bukan tugas sendirian, tetapi pasti tugas kolaborasi, tugas partisipatif, dan melibatkan banyak institusi. Itu saja sih yang bisa kami sampaikan, dan kami berharap semoga kesempatan ini bisa terus belajar ya. Dan saya terus terang ingin ikut ambil bagian karena juga diajak oleh Pak Ari. Ya. Pak Ari ini juga sebagai motor di kampus kami, dan kami ingin terlibat aktif juga sekalipun sebagai pimpinan, tentunya aktivitas itu juga harus di-direction dengan contoh. Ya, semoga dengan demikian kita semua dapat terus bersama mengkolaborasikan kepentingan green economy di Indonesia. Matur nuwun, terima kasih Ibu Eliana dan Bapak Agustino.
Baik, terima kasih Pak Priyo for your kind remarks. And then for now we are going to enter the mark of the beginning of the partnership. Here are the signage of the list of the agreement that has been signed by the six university. There is Universitas Brawijaya, Trisakti, Atmajaya Yogyakarta, 11 Maret, and Pembangunan Jaya. Also, Universitas Widya Kartika. Please give a round of applause for all of us here today. And thank you for the collaboration, hopefully in the future, and we can make the most of this agreement. And I think that will end the ceremonial for today.
Walaupun tidak disampaikan salam dari Brawijaya.
Oh, Brawijaya?
Regards from the Brawijaya University, yes.
Oh, Brawijaya. Ah, baik Bapak, mohon maaf sekali.
Silakan no Pak. Problems.
Bapak, I'm so sorry, Pak Hadi Suyono. Silakan Bapak untuk sambutannya.
Oke, thank you very much. Sorry, Mbak Anggita, ya. Oke, the honorable and respected guys, the acting leads Indonesia Green Building Program IFC, Mr. Angelo Tan, hello, Mr. Tan. And then Head of Swiss Economic Cooperation, SICO, Mr. Philip Orga. Hello, Mr. Philip. Yeah, Mr. Orga. And then Dean of Faculty Engineering and Designs, University Trisakti, Dr. Hadi Prabowo. And then Dean of Faculty Engineering, Universitas 11 Maret, Dr. Teh Solihin Asad. And then Dean of Faculty Engineering, Universitas Atmajaya, Yogyakarta, Dr. Eng Lukian Doko, and then Dean of Faculty of Technology and Design, University Pembangunan Jaya, Bapak Agustinus Agustiawan, Rector of Universitas Widya Karya Kartika, Bapak A.F. Priyo Suprobo, and all distinguished participants at this meeting. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and good morning. First of all, I would like to thank you for the invitation and cooperation that has been initiated and has been carried out by our institutions. It is an honor for us to be a part of these collaborations. I would like to express my sincere appreciation also to the organizer of this event, especially IFC and SICO. And then, as we know, the development of the civilization is now reaching the era of Industry 4.0 and Society 5.0. An important pillar of sustainability is sometimes forgotten, which is the ecological era. Yeah, awareness of the ecological era become the solution of today environmental problem, which is the continuously increasing carbon emission that have an impact on climate change. And then the Faculty of Engineering of Universitas Brawijaya has contributed significantly to climate change adaptations by establishing a research group on low carbon emission study since 2020. One of these research groups activities focuses on the study on environmentally friendly or green building through various experimental research using computer simulation tool. In line with this focus, the cooperation agreement between the IFC and the Faculty of Engineering of UB may become a way for mutually beneficial collaboration. The Faculty of Engineering of Universitas Brawijaya plays an important role in producing human resources for development, including graduates who have the ability to design environmentally friendly building in the future. And then, for your information, Faculty of Engineering of Universitas Brawijaya manages 9 departments and 19 study programs, including civil, architect, urban planning, water resources, and then electrical, mechanical, chemical, and profession engineers. We have about 6,800 for the students, and then we have around 274 lectures. As the Dean of the Faculty Engineering of Brawijaya, allow me to extend our deepest appreciation for these collaborations and implementation of training of trainers, TOT, of Design for Greater Efficiencies, DFGE, Indonesia, as a real step to preserve our earth. Thank you very much. Good morning and assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Terima kasih Mbak Anggita.
Waalaikumsalam. Thank you Pak Hadi Suyono for the remarks. Mohon maaf Bapak, tadi ternyata terskip. Saya pikir tadi saya sudah memanggil Bapak. And thank you for all the work that has been done to promote sustainability to your student, Bapak. Hopefully this program able to assist you on continuing your mission to promoting sustainability. And I think I haven't shared the agreement yet when I said, tadi sebelumnya saya belum share screen ya ternyata Bapak Ibu untuk yang agreement.
Belum.
Ya, baik. Kalau begitu kita ulang ya Bapak Ibu supaya sah untuk kita kerjasamanya pada hari ini. So, I will share my screen. Yeah, so this is the 6th agreement that has been signed between the 6 university and IFC, between Universitas Brawijaya, Trisakti, Atmajaya Yogyakarta, Universitas 11 Maret, dan Universitas Pembangunan Jaya, serta Universitas Widya Kartika. Hopefully this agreement will help us to supporting sustainability to the future generation. Please give a round of applause for this one. Hopefully we can see this agreement now in your screen. Okay. So for that, I think this is the end of our ceremonial session for this morning. And we will continue the session with the training of trainers for all the faculty members. And thank you very much for your time and also for being with us today. Terima kasih banyak Bapak dan Ibu atas waktu dan kehadirannya pada pagi hari ini. Kita berharap semoga kerjasama ini bisa membantu Bapak dan Ibu dan universitas-universitas yang ada di sini, serta membuat inspirasi juga untuk universitas-universitas lain untuk semakin mendorong keberlanjutan dan juga mengimplementasikan bangunan gedung hijau di Indonesia. Dan selamat pagi dan terima kasih.
Selamat pagi, terima kasih.
Oke, okay, thank you very much.
Selamat pagi.
Sampai jumpa lagi.
Oke, semuanya. Terima kasih. Terima kasih. Thank you, Angelo. Thank
terima kasih
you,
semuanya. Terima kasih.
Thank you, Professor Philip Orga, for your time. So, we will end the session here. And because we are using the same link, karena kita memakai link yang sama, untuk Bapak dan Ibu yang akan mengikuti training of trainers, harap stay. Kita akan memulai pada pukul 10.30, jadi bisa break sebentar. Kemudian, untuk for all the guests dan untuk para tamu lainnya yang tidak mengikuti training of trainers, mungkin bisa leave dari ruang meeting ini. Terima kasih.
Terima kasih. Thank you.
Terima kasih.
Thank you, Mr. Orga.
Thank you, Mr. Orga. Thank you.
Terima kasih.